Hi guys, this is Super Sam once again, and in this video we're so excited to show you a new add-on that's coming out very soon from the stables of Levonotion Studios, and the add-on is called Translational Walk Aid. This add-on helps you to translate your walk cycle or help you create a walk of your character, any character that has been rigged with any of these three different rigging system in Blender, which are Auto Rig Pro, Rigify, or BlenRig. So it helps you translate your character forward. You can either use a pre-existing walk cycle or you can create your walk all together from scratch, you know. And I'm going to show you an example of how I converted a walk cycle using the help of this translational walk aid as a tool to help me move my character forward. And then I would like to show you what the walk looks like. So this is what we have, nothing too fancy. I think I would like to create the floor, so this makes more sense. Shift A, just drop in a plane right there. Okay, then I'm gonna make this, just gonna lock that out so I can't accidentally select it. All right, so my aim here is to make this walk cycle transform forward, right? Of course, you can ask, why not just animate on the Z axis of my root here to make the character walk forward? You can also do this, but the downside to this is most people really don't know how to do it, because when you do it, you get your feet sliding, and of course getting a sliding feet for a character walk is not the best. So you want a solution that is very sure and certain, and that is what this transitional aid gives you. So enough of talks, let's go to action. So I'm just gonna reset back to my original position, and I'm taking this back to frame one. So from here, I want to show you how you can install the add-on. I already have it installed here, as you can see. So just go to edit and then preferences, then click on install and go to the directory where your add-on is, and then install the add-on. But since I already have the add-on installed, this is what I'm gonna see here. So TWA Translational Walk Aid. I have for three other rigs currently installed on my PC. So this is for the Auto Rig Pro, this is for the BlenRig, and this is for Rigify. And this first one here is just the bundle that has all three rigs in one. So I'm just gonna use that to make my work faster. So now, when you have the add-on installed and you activate it on the panel here, this is what it looks like with the button Get Started. So I'm just gonna click on the Get Started. After clicking on the Get Started, you're gonna see other information pop up. Right now, if I'm using the wrong rig here, I'm not gonna see this information. I'm gonna get an error note. Wrong rig in the sense that using any rig that is different from Auto Rig Pro, Rigify, or BlenRig. So those are wrong rig according to what this add-on understands. So for here, I have the option to also change my rig type. Okay, you can change from Rigify to Auto Rig Pro or BlenRig. And if you don't have any rig corresponding to any of these three, it's not gonna work. Now, you can see you have the move left foot forward. So let me see what my character pose currently looks like. Okay, so I have the left foot at the back. So when I click on left foot forward, the character's left foot goes forward, as you can see. You can take it backwards, then move right foot forward, right? So now it's walking off the screen. Okay, so you can make him walk forward or backwards, just like that, right? So let me reset back to what we had initially. And if you go down here, you can see translate with keyframes. Now this option would help you input, as a user, input the number of steps you need and also the keyframe interval. So for a walk, most times a normal walk uses a 12 frame interval, right? So if I'm doing a normal walk, like I'm going to show you here now, I'm going to use a 12 frame interval. But if I'm doing a run cycle, for example, we previously had a video on how to tutorials that shows how to animate a run cycle, and we used the interval of 7 in that particular video. In this case, I'm just going to change my interval to 7, right? But for what we have here, 12 interval is fine for a normal walk. So I'm just going to leave the interval as 12. And the number of steps, I want the character to take, let's just go with 4 steps. It's just an example, so I don't want to go all crazy, but you can go as far as possible with this. And as soon as I click on this move step style, it's going to move the character 4 steps forward or backward depending on the button that is clicked here. And aside from that, you also have your keyframe set in place as well. So I'm going to show you how these can be used to your benefit. Now the first thing I want to do is, since I know the add-on only bothers about the Y translate, that is the forward translate of this character, I'm just going to delete every information I have on the Y translate. And before I do that, I want to take out the loop, the cycle that I already have going. Like I said, this is a walk cycle. So for this exercise, I don't want it to be a cycle. Now I'm just going to just reveal everything, because I don't know all the controls that have been keyframed and I don't want to make any mistake here. So just reveal everything, then A to select all, and you want to go to the graph editor, select one of the channels, Alt H to unhide all channels, then A to select all the keyframes here, then the period key to frame selected, and now you can see the curve extending beyond my actual keyframes here. So that's the cycle. So I'm just going to go to channel, and then I'll go to extrapolation mode and clear cyclic. So when you clear cyclic, you can see everything stops. Yeah, so this is what you want. That's the first cleanup you want to do. Now the second cleanup is, I'm going to my Y channel for this, Shift H and GY to move it forward and be sure. Okay, so I think that's the correct channel, GY. Okay, so that moves forward and backward. Okay, so I'm gonna delete the keyframes that I have right on that channel, so that's fine. So I'm doing the same thing too for this channel Y, Shift H. Delete all the keyframes you have on the channel, and then you have just one keyframe on frame 1. So I'm gonna do the same thing for the torso, because those are the important part of a walk. So location Y, Shift H, select and delete every other keyframe. Okay, so my rig had been cleaned up now, and when I play my animation, this is what you get. Okay, so it looks horrible now because I have no information on the Y translate, and that is what you want. So this time around, I just need to go back to the add-on and start the walk. So here I have 4 steps already and 12 frames interval. So I'm just go in there, and now I'm gonna click on move step style 1. Let's see what that gives. Now you can see it pushes my character forward, and I have additional keyframes here right? Initially, I had my keyframes up to frame 25, but now I have it on frame 97. And when I scrub, you can see the character actually walking forward, and suddenly the motion stops. And that's because I no longer have my cycle animation on the character. So now that I already have my character walking forward and the number of steps, let's count the steps for you to see how many steps we actually have. You're supposed to have 4 steps here. So we have the right foot forward here. When I scrub, that's step 1. So you having 1, this is the complete step. That's the complete step, that's 1. Then bam, bam, that's 2. Bam, bam, that's 3. Bam, bam, that's 4. So you have 4 full steps, right? So it's time to copy and paste my loop animation on every other frame, right? And I need to lock my Y channel to do so. So lock the Y location, and also lock the Y location for the right foot. Then I'm gonna lock the Y location for the left foot. Now, the reason why I chose to lock these channels is I don't want to paste any keyframe on that channel, because I already have the right keyframe that pushes my character forward on the Y channel. So once this is done, the next step you want to do is just select everything, and you can see how simple this is. Select everything and deselect the roots, because you don't need the roots there, right? And then I'm just going to 1. So remember, your frame 1 and frame 5 are supposed to be the same. So I'm just gonna Control C to copy, then go to frame 25, okay, and paste. Control V to paste. Go to frame 49, Control V to paste. Go to 73, paste, and you have the last one on 97. And now when you scrub back, you should see your character walk forward without any issues. So I'm just gonna hide the rig there for you to see what is going on. And you can see my character walking very, very fast. You don't even have to bother yourself worrying about how much you should push the roots, okay? And another thing is, I want you to see how the character walks away from the roots, okay? Just see that. And that's nice. I like to turn off other controls. I'm gonna leave the roots. So you have this, the character walking off. So I'm still gonna do another video on how you can create your walk from scratch, taking advantage of the power of this toolkit. So this works for Rigify. If I switch to a different one, like Auto Rig Pro, I'm gonna get an error that wrong rig selected. And if I go to BlenRig as well, I'm gonna get the same error, wrong rig selected. So it only works with Rigify when I'm on Rigify. And that's all. So we're just so excited to share this with you guys. We would like to know what you think about this walk aid, and see you when we see.